Jonathan Coppess, University of Illinois.
So I'm Jonathan Coppess, Director of the Gardner Agriculture Policy Program here in the College of Aces, University of Illinois. And we're talking about the cover crop analyzer, a web-based decision support tool for farmers in Illinois looking to adopt the cover crop practice, which helps cut nutrient loss, helps reduce nutrient loss. And we just launched the first version of this, our beta version of the cover crop tool, in which a producer can log in, pick a field, one of their fields, and run a cover crop growing in that field over the course of what would normally be the fallow time. Be able to see the impacts of that cover crop, everything from the biomass accumulation to the nitrogen uptake. And this is an indicator of what that cover crop is doing. It helps the farmer make management decisions around that cover crop termination, the commercial crop planting time frame. And we hope it's the first of many iterations or additional functionalities that we would like to put into this to help farmers as they think through the adoption process for cover crops and then manage that cover crop in the field. This is the first version of this. This is the initial rollout that just came out last week. Right now, we're only including cereal rye as the cover crop to use. That's kind of the first level of cover crop practice. It survives the winter and starts growing back in the spring, so we've got a lot of information around that. Right now, that tool will give you a default set of information around your fertilizer application rates, time, all of that, your seed population for your crop, your commercial crop, and your cover crop, cereal rye. And you go into that My Farm, the farmer can actually revise that, so move out of the default and get to your actual. So we've got, for example, we're showing 172 pounds. Maybe you're putting on more or less than that, and then you can adjust the way the model is taking that in. Because this model is taking in your soil information, the weather data, and that practice information to be able to run the simulated cover crop growth. You come into the analyzer, you're going to start a job. You're presuming you've got farms entered into this. So I'm going to start a job using this Church Road test from 9:29. Again, we're starting the day after the harvest time. So we're going to presume that the day after harvest is the establishment of the cover crop or the planting of the cover crop. You may have done that earlier, but for running the model, we kind of have to stick to that. We have to keep our dates clearly separate. I can choose weather patterns. The hottest year in the last 10 years, the coldest year in the last 10 years, or the average weather in the last 10 years, using the Illinois State Water Survey actual data for the area. So again, what we're showing then, this initial dashboard, and this is just sort of the first step, right? There's a lot of functionality we want to add to this, but this is the first step of what does that cereal rye cover crop look like in my field projecting average weather into April of 2021. The first thing you're going to notice is the blue line is the plant biomass. This is our growth. We're adding biomass every day until we sort of take that dormant period during the winter months, and then once we sort of thaw out and start growing again, we're going to add biomass to an estimated 2,076 pounds per acre of plant biomass from cereal rye if my termination is based on a planting date of April 29th. I've got a two-week window built into this to give you an idea, or we've got a two-week window built in there to give you an idea of, the likelihood you actually hit your planting date is obviously not great. At the same time, we're calculating your carbon to nitrogen ratio. So for the farmer who's thinking about adding cover crops into the field, these are the first two critical numbers to think about. How much biomass is in that field? How much am I going to have to plant through because it's a living crop that's out there? And my carbon to nitrogen ratio of 26, we're telling you that anything from 0 to 20, this carbon to nitrogen ratio is an estimate of breakdown, of decomposition. So this crop has taken up nitrogen over time. It's storing it in its biomass. That's the carbon to nitrogen ratio. The higher that ratio, the longer it's going to take to break down. Right? And so the longer we would expect that nitrogen to be locked up. This begins to sort of initiate decisions around, say, a starter fertilizer to help the crop growing because we've got a lot of nitrogen locked up. In this case, we're estimating 30 pounds per acre has been taken up by that cover crop over by that cereal rye and is held in the crop's biomass. We also calculate then the reduction in the amount of nitrogen we would expect to have not lost because it's now in the cover crop. And here we're about 5.3 pounds per acre reduced from loss. And that's about a 12% reduction. And that is, again, calculated on the simulation of the rye. If we look a little bit deeper into the uptake numbers, so here's our nitrogen, what we are estimating or simulating is the nitrogen changes in that field because there's a cover crop. Again, we have a cover crop in, so it is taking up nitrogen over time, and this is getting us to our poundage, right? So we're, if we go, you know, another thing you look at is you go deeper into this, the more it's going to take up. It's going to change that number. Same with our soil inorganic nitrogen in the field, with the cover crop, without the cover crop, right? And so this cover crop has taken nitrogen and stored it, so there's less nitrogen in the field for that. So here again, in future efforts, we want to look around how we think about things like starter nitrogen for that crop. And then our nitrogen loss reduction number, again, this is the measurement of what we've lost to our tile drain. So if we have a cover crop in there, it's one amount. And you can see the comparison then. This is where we get our estimated reduction in loss. And you know, one of the things you can start to think through is the longer that sits there, right, the more we have prevented from being lost. But now we're challenged with more biomass, we're challenged with more nitrogen locked up in the biomass. You can adjust the windows then to look a lot closer around that date. And again, you may not hit the exact date. And so the critical features initially are just giving the farmer information around what that cover crop is doing in the field and what the impacts might be then for the commercial crop that you're looking to follow. This has been generously funded over the last 3 years by Illinois NREC, and we've had some great feedback from farmers and from the NREC board, working in conjunction with the Ag and Biological Engineering as well as the National Center for Supercomputing Applications here on campus, as a combined effort to take research from the labs and from the field trials and plug it into the farmer's hand through the web-based applications technology and development capabilities here on campus. So we hope it helps farmers with this important practice, helps cut our nutrient loss, improve our soil health, and improve our waters in the state of Illinois.